Oh yeah, Kratos. Nice, we got a 5-player game. Red is novice. Orange is beginner. Green is intermediate. Yellow is beginner. So I'm the highest ranked player in the lobby, which means that they might target me. Or they're at least going to respect me a lot more and be careful about me. In terms of how the map is set up, I actually have a lot of units towards Europe. So that's a pretty clear Europe game for me. So my immediate reaction is I need to secure these two threes, because if I'm not careful, they'll get killed. So I need to unify these two threes. This whole chain that I've got going right here is very naturally going to stay unified. So I'm not really worried about it. Yeah, see how these guys are already leaving Europe a little bit, so I just need to worry about these threes. The problem is that I get like one of the last turns. My turn is fourth. So nothing I can do about this situation. Wow, red left themselves in a very weak position. Yeah, sure, red got Australia turn one, but green could easily break this. And green has no other continents to go for. So I think red made a mistake putting themselves in such a weak position. Let's see what green does. I predict that green's gonna start making a play towards Australia. If not now, then maybe... If not now, then it might be too late because they'll get a plus five. Yeah, okay, that's the right move. Yeah, so green's gonna break that. It should. Five should beat three. Oh, are they gonna... No, don't wait. If you unify this, they're gonna get a plus eight. Plus five, that's eight. Oh, it's too slow. I think it's too... I disagree with green's move there. If you're gonna go for it, just go for it, you know? That's too slow. Alright, I'm not really worried about this situation up here anymore because I saw green already go this way. So I'm gonna instead turn my attention towards how do I get control of Europe. How do I get control of Europe? This 3, I'm not worried about it because red's gonna defend down here. So this 2, I can leave there for a second longer. Or I can attack to the left. I'll attack to the left. I'll get out of the way. And I'll fortify. Yeah, so I'm just establishing that I'm definitely going to take Europe. I've got all of my units towards Europe. So this green better get out of the way. And green is incentivized to move this 5 anyways because they want to get units towards this 8. So the 5 might attack the 2 in order to get to the 8. Yellow's going to try and defend and fight orange for South America. That's interesting. And I'm glad that I moved this out of the way so that this can fight each other and I don't have to worry about it. So yeah, these threes are actually pretty safe up here. If anything, like maybe he'd take this three and head towards the five and then try and bring it down. But I can just next turn attack down into the right. So these threes are very safe. Oh yeah, actually the three can just come down and around me, but I'll move out of the way. Yeah, see, this is exactly what I was telling you. Like, instead of a 5 attacking a 3, now it's an 8 defending against an 8. Like, red is able to defend this very easily now, so I don't know what green was thinking. Yeah, this is... Oh, man. Poor green. What are you doing, dude? You did this to yourself. Oh! Oh my god, why would red do that? Just leave it as an 8. Why would you attack it? Now green can definitely penetrate into Indonesia and start attacking Australia. And red has nothing to defend it with. Look at red's units are so far away. That's a major mistake by red. That's a very, very bad move. So orange needs to unify this 4 with the 9 and bring this 4 down as well. Yeah, Orange should probably move this 2 over. See, in the early game, you need to be very focused on preservation. Because you have very low unit counts. It's very easy to lose troops and fall into a bad position. Yeah, Green is almost definitely going to take Australia now. Wow. That 5 should still come down anyways. Maybe red's gonna go for Africa now. This 2 and this 3 should unify and then maybe go to Africa. That's reasonable. I agree with you. And this 5 here is very secure, so I'm gonna leave that there. I'm gonna unify my 3s now. So yeah, basically I haven't been attacked at all. Right? That's my entire strategy. Is unify all my units together, make sure nothing gets attacked. So all my units up here are very safe, all my units right here are very safe, this 5 is very safe. Next thing I'll do is I'll start throwing units into Europe and then taking over Europe one at a time. I don't need to take Europe very quickly because nobody else has a continent. Right, so these guys are fighting over a continent, these guys are fighting over a continent. I got plenty of time to take Europe. Now if I rush to take Europe, that would give me a big advantage, but again, I don't want to get caught with my pants down having attacked too quickly. I want to give red a chance to get these units out of here. This 2 is probably not going to leave because yellow is going to invest a lot of units into South America, so I could just kill the 2. And this 3 has a chance to move over and join the red, join the 5. So that'll bring my 7 into Europe. So this is a very good setup that I have in North America. I just need to get this 5 over as soon as possible. Oh, we'll wait, see what happens. Why are you attacking with a 4? Don't attack with a 4. That's like punching up. Oh... What are you doing, bro? What are you doing? What are you doing? Red is just angry. Red is just pissed. Oh, Red is just pissed. What are you doing? Red is just suiciding and forfeiting. Red gave up on this game. It's just a series of bad moves. That's okay. They're a novice. They're new at the game. Okay. So, what do I want to do? I think I'll leave the 5 and the 6 here to keep this border very strong, and I'll use my 4 to clear out the rest of Europe. Red had a chance? Yeah, definitely. Red definitely can still win. Like, even right now, red could still be fine. It's just that red just threw away a bunch of units. And that's the difference between, like, me and red, right? Like, red just was constantly on the attack, and I didn't attack anybody. I'm just unifying my units, clumping them together. That's how you want to play your early game, especially when there's this many players on the board. It's 5 players. Plenty of time. The biggest reason why you fall behind in the early game is probably because you're attacking too much. And then you just lose units unnecessarily. But if you can just avoid attacking, I always try and attack ones, right? Alright, so red left the game, and that clears up everything here for me. I think I could take Europe on my next turn, actually, and I don't think anyone's going to contest me. Maybe orange, but highly unlikely. So I could just take my 5, 1, 2, 3, boom, boom, boom. That's it. That's an 8, 3. It's a little fast. Oh, orange is giving up on South America. Okay. Oh, is orange going for Australia? What? That would be crazy. Oh, orange is gonna start positioning for Africa. Okay, okay. So there's a big 10 right here. So if I take Europe too quickly and spread myself too thin, then orange might attack me. So I have to be very, very careful about that. So I'm going to take Europe very slowly is my plan. This 3 is going to sit there for a very long time. It's a little bit annoying, but it's fine. I'm going to group. Because I want my 10 to be the same size as that 10, so I don't lose units. If 10 takes my 1, it's no problem. So that means yellow's gonna definitely take South America on this turn. What? That 4 lost to a 1. Oh my goodness, yellow's pissed. Yeah, the thing is 4 doesn't always beat a 1. You should probably upgrade it to like a 6 or a 7 before you attack. 6 or 7, I feel very comfortable. Yeah. Alright, so meanwhile, red rejoined the game and continues to suicide units, giving them absolutely no chance of getting back into the game. And I don't even know why red bothered to reconnect if they're just going to suicide everything. Orange, as long as orange goes through and takes Africa, then I can finish off Europe. So then your orange and I can form an alliance. Let's see what orange does. The other nice part about moving my units out of Southern Europe is that it kind of represents a non-threat to Orange. I want Orange and I to be on the same team. So the reason Yellow didn't take South America is because Orange didn't take Africa yet. But I don't like that move from Yellow. I think Yellow should have attacked a little bit faster and finished off South America. Now Orange, you know, theoretically is going to get a bunch of units next turn. Maybe could attack Yellow back. I'm going to ask Orange for an alliance. If Orange does not accept my alliance, I'll have to be a little bit worried. I don't know if there's anything I can do about it. Wow, Green lost a lot of units just now. I could actually attack Green. I have a set. I could actually attack Green right now. Holy crap. Do I want to do that? What if I attack Green? Holy crap, I could attack Green right now. I'm just going to do it. I'd rather have that than Europe. Is that the play? Or do I just take Europe and be safe? Do I declare war on Green or do I take Europe and play safe? Oh, what kind of game do I want to play? A Europe game or an Australia game, chat? What do you want to see? I don't have a strong preference, but I think if it were me, I would probably go for Australia because I like playing Australia. Get EU. It's a safe play. I'll play safe. Sure, why not? So we've got Europe. See, the thing is, Orange could attack me, but he knows I'll attack him right back with my 20. So, and I already offered Orange an alliance. So I've already told Orange in many different ways that I'm not a threat. The real threat is Yellow, right? Because Yellow and Orange have been a little bit hostile towards each other. I'm going to unify my 5 over to my 20. This will be a very big 30. It'll be a very big threat. People will start to respect me and start to get a little bit scared, actually. I need to be careful of that. Now, if Yellow attacks through here over to Western Europe, I could easily slap Yellow back through the same route. But we'll see. Yeah, is Yellow a little bit threatened by me? That's the question. If Yellow attacks me here, that means they're threatened by me. And then I would have wished that it went for Australia instead. If you attack me, Yellow, you know I'm going to attack you back. Yeah, Yellow's not going to dare. Wow, so Yellow just made a big enemy with Orange, right? I mean, Orange is not very powerful right now. But Orange is like a buffer between me and Yellow. Then they're leaving a 5 there. So Yellow's saying, I don't want Orange to be powerful in the slightest. That's a big statement. Orange is in a lot of trouble because they don't have enough units, but they do have 4 cards. So Orange could do a turn in and then attack Yellow. And now Yellow and Orange are fighting each other. And now I have control of Europe and Yellow and Orange are fighting each other. That would put me in a very, very good position. So here comes that turn in from Orange. And here comes Orange retaliating against Yellow. Wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. And the thing about Orange's move right there is that it's not even a sustainable move. Like, Yellow is just going to take that right back, and Orange would have wasted all of their cards. So it's really, really good for me, because that means no one's going to attack me anytime soon. But it's really, really bad for Orange, because Orange just does not have as many units to either take back Africa or to sustain that attack on South America. So I'm going to do my unification move as I talked about. And I'm going to fortify my position. And the reason I would do this is because I know these guys are not gonna attack me, and if Green dares attack South Europe, I'm just gonna slap him all the way through to Australia. So Green will not attack me either. So as long as I make this 31 as big as possible, no one's gonna attack me. And then I just need to close off Greenland, and then I'm safe. So I'll move my 7 over to Greenland, and then I should be able to sustain this position for a very long time. And I'm in first place by a lot, and I have the best continent out of everybody. You want to see war? Well, let's see. The winning position is to either kill another player or to... Well, yeah, that's... I mean, right now we want to kill another player. So we want to kill the player with the most cards, because that will give us additional units. So for example, if we killed Green, then we would get 5 cards, which is worth about, you know, 15 or 20 units, which is a lot. So I would definitely consider killing Green right now. But Green does move before me, so it's only going to be 2 cards. Okay. So how's Green going to use those cards? Are they going to attack me? Are they threatened by me? No. Green is going to turtle. So Green and I are entering a period of peace, which is very good for me because my position is better than Green's. It's very, very good for me. Okay. So I'm in a very, very strong position right now. It does appear that yellow and orange formed a truce, but that's not going to last very long because we know that yellow doesn't like that orange has Africa. So this attack's going to keep happening over and over again. So orange has got to try and stabilize, but yellow's pretty mean. If they enter this truce, then my hold of Europe becomes a lot less powerful. I want these guys to keep attacking each other, ideally. It does appear that they're forming this truce, though. Okay, all right. Meanwhile, keep an eye on Green here. Green has been turtling. Green does not want to upset me by attacking Southern Europe. It looks like Red left the game again. So we need to try and figure out which player needs to be killed. And then we have to ask ourselves, should we be the ones to kill that player or should someone else be the one? We should probably kill Red because Red doesn't have a continent. So Red is the weakest player. But I don't want it to be me because it's very expensive to kill somebody. So I don't want to be the one to kill Red. I might want to be the one to finish off Red, but I don't want to be the one that starts the attack on Red, especially when there's so many high number countries here. It's very expensive. I do have a turn in right here. Yeah. I have 18 units, that becomes 24 units. Could I kill Red? I could also kill Red on next turn, right? I'll just kill Red next turn. It's fine. Right? So when Red gets a little bit more valuable to me, like it's 4 or 5 cards, then it's worth killing Red. Right? Because then I'll have enough compensation for how much it costs me to kill Red. And this is kind of nice that there's a 4 over here randomly, because even if Green tries to kill Red, they can't because they're blocked by their own Alaska. So Green can attack Red and clear out Red a little bit, but cannot kill Red, which means that only I could kill Red. Orange also cannot kill Red, they don't have enough units. But I could be the one to kill Red. This is good for me. I can let Red live another turn. I also grow at a rate that's larger than that, faster than Red, right? Because Red only gets 3 units per turn. I get 8 units per turn. Okay, it does look like that Red got lucky and got a set, so that lost all those cards. So it's no longer worth it to kill Red. We need to wait for Red to build up some more cards here. I'm not exactly in a rush to clear Red off the field though, because the longer Red stays on the field, the easier it is for me to hold on to Europe. As long as Red is a partial threat to Green, Green will not attack me. So Yellow's going to try and start taking back some of North America, but That shouldn't be a very good proposition for yellow, because there's a lot of red units here. Plus, they know that I've got this Greenland. So yellow can never fully capture North America. Yellow's just trying to get cards by taking one country at a time. I'll do the same thing. I'll just keep getting bigger. So I'm spreading my units out intentionally now. Before, I was trying to threaten people, right? So I had a big 30, and I'm like, if you attack me, I'm gonna attack you right back. But now, I don't want to appear too large, because then people will start to attack me. They'll be too scared of me. So I'm intentionally spreading out my units. Green, on the other hand, is intentionally trying to stack their units up, because they're very, very small. Green is a very, very small position, right? They only have 6 countries. So Green is intentionally trying to beef up Siam and say, like, I'm very big, don't attack me. But they're actually very weak. Not very weak, but like, they're weak. Yellow has a lot of room to work with. Orange has the second largest continent by rate, right? Because this Africa gets +3, whereas these other guys are only getting +2. So he wants to hold on to this position as long as possible. This 17 and this 15, keep an eye on that border there, because remember, these guys already have a history of not liking each other. So the larger this border gets, the more inclined they'll be to attack each other. So you see, this buildup right here shows distrust between these two players. I'm gonna get a 12 units next turn with my Great Britain bonus. So this is really, really good for me. I'm building up a lot of power. And again, we can kill red at any time, right? So we're just waiting for red to build up some cards to make it valuable enough to be worth killing. So I'll do my turn in. Perfect. So I made that a 40 to make sure that this 24 knows that they can't attack me. If the 24 even tries to do anything stupid, I'll slap back with the 40. So it's still a deterrent. So that's why you never put your units right on the borders. See how these guys are putting their units right on the borders? It's a threatening move. By removing my units off of the borders, it's not a threat. It's just it's a threat, but it's not an outward attack. These guys could attack each other. I can't attack. But I'm just saying, hey, don't attack my border, otherwise I'm gonna slap you back. It's a deterrent. Since 13 has been there this whole time, but yellow's kind of running out of room, right? Because yellow wants cards, but we're not giving them cards. So I could do yellow a favor and take a country here in order to give yellow cards. That's one option. Or I could just keep fighting over here, which will give orange more cards. So the question is, who do I like more, yellow or orange? So the thing is, orange is already growing faster than yellow is. So I want to be kind of nice to yellow, because I don't want them to attack me, but at the same time, you know, I don't have to be nice to yellow, and then this border is going to grow, and then they could attack each other. And yellow's going to get squeezed that way. But I want the game to stay the same size. I want the game to stay like this for as long as possible, because I have the biggest continent. So in order to keep this position sustainable, I need to help yellow. So I'm going to help yellow. So that's going to give yellow a chance to get cards. And that will keep this border growing. And the longer this border grows, the more they're gonna hate each other and attack each other, hopefully, eventually. If these two attack each other and suicide into each other, then my units is bigger than Green's, and then I'll win the game. That's my plan. So I want this to grow. This also gives me an excuse to put more units on Greenland, so that way yellow never takes North America fully. And also, I can resist any attacks from red. You want me to kill Orange. If I kill Orange, that kind of puts me in a vulnerable position to both Green and Yellow. So it would be risky for me to kill Orange. It'd be very expensive for me to kill Orange. Orange is actually the only thing preventing Yellow from attacking me, really. So even though Orange didn't accept my alliance request, Orange is my ally. Everyone's waiting for an opportunity. Exactly. And that's exactly the type of situation that I'm trying to create. I intentionally want this period of the game to last for as long as possible because I'm getting the most units out of everybody. So I'm intentionally dragging out this phase. So for example, remember earlier we talked about how I could have killed Red? If I did, that would make the game progress to the next stage. And I don't want the game to progress to the next stage. I just want to keep holding on to the largest continent. So the fact that Red is alive is intentional. If I wanted the game to move forward, I would have to kill like Red. Yeah. But this whole trading situation is actually making my army very, very large. So I'm gonna keep. I'm gonna keep trading cards with Yellow, so that way Yellow can get cards. But Yellow can also get cards from Red now, so. I need to find a way to get this 3 onto this 42. I think what I'm gonna do is one of these turns I'm gonna attack, and then move the 3, and then attack, and then move back. So it'll eventually rejoin, but it's kind of annoying. Oh! Are they attacking? Yes! It finally happened. It finally happened. And now Yellow goes for me. But that's fine, right? Yellow already hurt themselves a lot. So, and actually for some reason, Yellow didn't kill Orange completely. So, I could take all of Orange's cards, right? Oh, no, that's not true. Orange moves before me. Alright, okay. That's okay. I don't have Europe anymore, right? Yellow wanted to end this part of the game. But I could just kill Yellow. Actually, I can just kill Yellow. Oh my goodness, should I kill Yellow? Well, this would be like a 45. How much would it cost to kill Yellow and does it benefit me? It doesn't really benefit me to kill Yellow, actually, because Yellow's kind of restoring the balance of this game. Like, Orange is kind of restoring the balance of the game by taking back Africa. And actually, I made Yellow a little bit too powerful. So powerful that Yellow was able to bust through North Africa. So I made a mistake by helping Yellow get more cards. I'm gonna learn from my mistake by helping Orange now. I'm no longer going to help Yellow because Yellow showed that they're not cool to me. So yeah, the balance has been restored, but this time, instead of helping Yellow get cards, I'm just gonna only attack these countries over here on the right. And I'm gonna let Red take over North America. We'll see. If Yellow keeps doing this... Yeah, see, Yellow actually didn't hurt me, right? They only attacked one. So I didn't get damaged at all in that attack. Wow. Wow, Yellow's a very, very, very dumb player, because now I can just kill Yellow next turn. And Red is still offline. I could kill Yellow and Orange and take both of their cards. But would that make me too weak? I could literally just kill both of them. I could just go kill this 5, and I could also migrate down and kill Yellow. I have this 25 over here that can kill Yellow as well. And this 64 is not big enough to face off against my 56. So I could just win the game very quickly in a second here. Okay, Orange is dead. I think the next turn I kill Yellow. And then I have 3 continents. And then I just stuff Green into a corner and I win. I think that's the play. That's one play I could make. Another play that I could make is I take Africa. No, I have to kill yellow either way. The only player is to kill yellow. Okay, fortify. So the 68 is going to attack up, left, down, and then wipe all this stuff out. So I need to unify my units in preparation for that. I'm going to unify on the 84. So that even if the 68 attacks the 11, I'll just attack with my 84. Oh, I shouldn't have attacked this, actually. I should have left the 11. I should have left the 1 there intentionally and then stacked the 84 and then the 68 would have to come this way. Dang, I made a mistake. I made a mistake by attacking Middle East. That's okay. Not a big deal. I'm so much bigger than green. I don't know what green could possibly do against me in this situation. And I've got another set right here. Oh my god. Can this go any better? He's not even going to move. He's so petrified. Perfect. As long as the situation lasts, I'm going to win because more continents is better, objectively. So I can just hold on to this. So I don't even need to attack green. I just need to make the game last as long as possible then. This is fine. If green's gonna not make moves, then I'm just gonna keep getting bigger. I will eventually get so big that I can just wipe out green in a single turn. I could actually probably wipe out green on the next turn, but let's see how many continents red lets me keep. Yeah, red's gonna let me keep, because red's a computer player right now since red left the game, so I could just keep getting bigger. Green has to do something about this. The thing is, it's very expensive for them to do anything because they have to attack a 22 and a 19, so we'll just keep this happening. This is fine. I'm going to unify my 11. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. It's honestly, just keep it going. Green's throwing for sure. I mean, green's playing for second place. That's what I would do if I was green. Play for second place. But green, if green wants to play for second place, they just attack up. They just clear out all the red stuff for me and then let me win the game that way. But yeah, green's playing for second place. Is Risk more fun than Civ? I just think it's more simple, so it's easier for me to understand. Do I have a set? No, I don't. Do I have enough units to take all of North America? Nah, I don't yet. I'm playing this perfectly. It's taking a couple more turns than I would like, but it's fine. I'm gonna kill green. It's fine. I could kill green next turn. I'm just wondering, should I take the risk or should I just keep building up? I mean, there's no point, right? Like, I still have two continents, even if red completes that. If green has a set, they should turn in, but if they don't, I'm just gonna kill them and take the four cards. Oh, they're retreating. Okay, that's a mistake, actually, because now I can kill... Can I kill red? I was thinking I could kill red. I could just leave that there. I could just wipe all this out. Yeah, I'll just do that. I'm like, there's a mistake in there somewhere. I don't know where it is, but there is one. It's like, I can do this. Look at that. Because he retreated, I could just take everything else. And then the 88 is still smaller than the 126. And he has to take a turn to move out anyways. Even if red attacks that, okay, fine. I mean, green has to do something about this next turn because I'm about to... Yeah, green has to do something about this. It's already clear that green doesn't have a set, otherwise they would have already turned in. Yeah, okay, great. I'll just take another card, I guess. Oh my god, look how many... Oh my goodness. I'll put it on Kamchatka, I guess. Solid game. That was the way that you guys recommended that I played it, right? Because I could have turned in my set and taken Australia, but I turned in my set and took Europe instead, which is the safe, conservative thing to do. And it's a pretty consistent way to get a win. So I think the key learning for that game was preserving that one section of the game for as long as I possibly could, right? Like, that section of the game dragged out for so long where I had the largest continent, and then it was just really easy to have the largest army and win the game. So, pretty good. What's up, Dagger? Hoo-wee! Love the risk gameplay. What sparked you to branch out as opposed to a few years back? I've been getting a lot of positive vibes on my recent risk content. Kutch really likes it. But also, like, people have been posting on my YouTube videos and saying they really like it. So I figure, why not give it a shot? I'm glad you guys like the risk.